So hello everyone, myself Pooja. I am from Red Hat and I am also a member of PyLadies. So today I am here to talk about the robot framework. It's a smarter way to automate your stuff. So you can automate your application end to end by using the robot framework. So let me give you an introduction of robot framework. So it's a generic automation framework which uses the test libraries, different test libraries. Either we can use the test libraries which are inbuilt, or we can use the extended libraries which we can build ourselves. So it's a generic test automation framework. It is used for acceptance testing and acceptance test driven development. Acceptance testing is a testing where we check whether the requirements and specifications mentioned to us are fulfilled or not. It has an easy to use tabular data syntax where we can define our data in a table format, so it is easy to maintain and we can modify it easily. And it utilizes a keyword driven testing approach. So keyword driven testing approach is an approach where you use the defined keywords and we give the data as an argument to the keywords. So the robot framework is hosted on GitHub. It is an open source framework where you can find the further source code, documentation and issue tracker. It is released under the Apache 2 license. To the slides. So as there are different frameworks like JBehave, Cucumber, so why should we use, what are the benefits of robot framework over the other framework? So first one is it enables easy to use tabular syntax for creating the test cases. So we can create our test data in the tabular syntax so that we can easily maintain it. And the test data is also easy to read and modify. It provides us to create usable high level keywords. Like robot, if we download the robot framework, there are inbuilt libraries. We can create our own keywords by using those keywords which are defined in the libraries. It provides easy to read reports and logs. So when we run the robot framework, we get easy to read reports in HTML format as well as XML format. So after the execution of robot framework, we get three reports. One is report.html, output.html and result.xml file. It supports Selenium for web testing and GUI. So we can use the Selenium libraries for this. If you want to do the web testing and different libraries we can use in this. It supports the data-driven test cases. Data-driven test cases are those test cases which use the data to derive the testing. And it has built-in support for variables. So as in every language has variables, so in robot framework, we can define our own variables and give them a value so that we can use it in our test cases. So let's discuss about the architecture of robot framework. It has a modular high-level architecture. It uses the test data. Test data are defined in the test files. We can define the test data in test files, and test file creates the test suits. So when we run the robot framework, it executes the test data, parses the test data, and executes the test libraries, functions defined in the test library. Test libraries can be inbuilt, or we can build it on ourselves according to our needs. Test library interact with the system under test, either directly or with using any test tools like driver. So let's get started with the robot framework. So what are the preconditions for robot framework? So robot framework is implemented in Python, and it can be extended with Java, Iron Python or PyPy. So before installing robot framework, one of our precondition is we should have an interpreter Python. So if you are using Windows, you need to install the Python. And if you are using a Unix system like Linux, it has pre-installed Python with it. So you need to install it. So we can install robot framework by using a simple command, pip install robot framework, and can verify it by using robot --version to verify which version we have installed. So currently the latest version robot framework 3.0, which is supported for Python 3. So you can install that one. So let's discuss about the test cases styles in which we can write our test cases to run the robot framework. So first one is keyword-driven style. So keyword-driven style is a simple style where we use the keywords given with the arguments. So if we want to write a simple test case to check the login page, so suppose we are giving a login page and we need to test it with different scenarios. So the keyword-driven approach will be like that. We open the login page input the username, input password. So these login input page, input name, input password are the keywords, and test are the arguments which we have given to them. So we will open the page, we'll give the username, password, we'll submit the credential, and then web page should be logged in. So if the test will pass, we will get a report in HTML format so that we can know whether our tests have passed or not. So this is the keyword-driven approach. So in data-driven approach, suppose we are giving a login page. So we need to test it with each and every possibilities, with invalid username, valid password, invalid password, invalid username. So each and every condition we need to cover. So in data-driven approach, we cover all those conditions with different sets of data. So this type of test style is used when we need to test same scenario with different sets of data set. So here, invalid username, we define the different arguments in the user table so that we can use in our test scenarios. Next is behavior-driven style. This style is used when we need to make understand our stakeholders who are non-technical, that what are the requirements. So it use a simple scenario like given, when, and then syntax. So given we specify the condition that what is given to us. Like given, login page is open. Then what should happen? Then what should, and then is the expected result, we should be outcome of the test. So in given, if the login page is open, and when we enter the valid username and password, the submit credential, then web page should be open. So then is the expected result. So this is the jerking style. Basically, it is used by the BDD, behavior driven development. So what are the different test libraries which we can use for robot framework? So it has three set. Like one is standard library. Standard libraries, we don't need to install it. Comes with the robot. As we install the robot framework, they are by default installed with it. So we don't need to install it. They are like operating system, date time libraries. Next is external libraries. They must be installed if we have a web application and we need to test it. Then we need to install an external library, Selenium 2 library, which is used for web UI testing. So we can install the external libraries also to meet our requirements. Next is other libraries. Like if you are given a project to test and you need your own functions and libraries, so you can create your own libraries and then can import in the test cases to use those functions in your test suits. So we can, as I have told you, that we can use the variables. So we can define the variable in variable test tables. So this is the syntax to define the variables. Like if we want to test a test case for different browser, like browser Internet Explorer, Firefox, so we can just put the browser as a variable and can change its value and can use in our test suits. So like login URL, which login URL. So this is a generic test. This is a generic variables defined. So you can also define the test setup and test teardown. So test setup are the test functions that are executed before a test case, and test teardown are the steps which are executed after the test execution. So you can define our test case setup and teardown in the setting key, in the setting table, like test setup, open application, we have need to open the application before and test suit, and we need to close our application after every test is executed. So there are a few steps we need to remember while following the robot framework, that we need to give at least two spaces between our keyword and the arguments. If we will give one spaces, it will consider a keyword and it will throw an error that it is an invalid keyword. So make sure you give minimum two spaces, or we can use 2 to 4 spaces also between our keyword and the arguments. So it has also a benefit that we have clear reports and log. Like if we have executed our test cases, so by seeing the report only we can tell that our test cases are passed. So the background will be green if all the critical test cases are passed. So by seeing only, anyone can tell, okay, the old test cases are passed now. And if any of the test cases fail, the background will be red. So we can came to know that anything has gone wrong, so our test cases has failed. And it also has this execution log, which is a detailed log, which tells us if any of our test cases fail. It tells us that at which point the test cases break and where we need to fix it. So it has a detailed execution log also. So let's see a demo now. Is it? able to see this? Okay. Yes. So this is a simple test case which I have written to test the FOSSASIA page, that whenever we open the FOSSASIA page, is the same page is open, we have to verify it and check it whether it will open or not. So in the setting table we need to define the library which we want to install. So in setting we can define the which library we want to install, either built-in or external libraries. And in setting, we also declare the test tier down or tier setup. So in tier down, I have defined that we have to close the browser after every test case is executed. And in variable, we need to specify the variable. Like I have used the browser for Firefox. So we need to test it against the Firefox. URL is HTTP FOSSASIA, page title. So after opening the page, it should check whether the title is a FOSSASIA or not, either some other page is logged in or not. So we have to verify that. And so test cases, in test cases table we define the test cases. So here the first test case is open FOSSASIA page. So I have in the documentation you can name your test, then open browser, we have given the URL which is defined in the variable table, then browser, then we maximizes the window to check whether the maximize button is operating or not. I have set the Selenium speed a little delay so that we can see it, and then we have to verify the page, but whether then we are verifying the page whether the FOSSASIA page is opened or not by using the keyword assert title. This assert title was not a defined keyword. I have defined it in keyword table. So we can create our own keyword from the higher level keywords. So I have created assert title, which is title should be equal to page title, and page title is a variable which is defined in the variable table. So let's run it and see how it works. We can write in by using the simple command robot. So it executing the test cases. So it's executing the first test case. And the FOSSASIA page should open. It should maximize it also. Let's see. So it basically saves our manual efforts which we do while testing. Now it's verifying that whether the FOSSASIA page was open or not. So after control shift. So after the test cases has been executed, this is the format which we get. Like if the test cases are pass, pass, pass and fail. For every test case we have a dot which you have seen, like if one of the test cases pass, dot, dot, then, and if the full test case is pass, then the and we can see this on web UI also, like Python, we can see the reports. Simple. We can see what it on simple HTTP. Oh, sorry. So let's see the reports on web UI. So these are the reports which are generated after the execution of. So this is the log.html where the we can see the logs,
and each test cases is defined here with the keyword that first was open FOSSASIA page, next we verified the page. So we can expand it and see what all the steps were executed in this and they were passed. If any of the one would be failed, then it will show fail and it will show the reason, like open browser, what the steps were executed in this. So it gives us a detailed view of our test cases. So it is easy to just go across them. So next is, I told you about the report. So this is a report which is generated after the test execution. As all our test cases pass, so this is a green report which we got. And other is the XML format, which is machine readable. So this is also a output of this. So where it is there? So for reference, you can go to robot.framework.org or you can follow the quick guide or user guide for your reference. So any questions till now? We can also integrate our framework with like tools like Jenkins, like in our day-to-day life when we are doing testing, we get the build overnightly or in a week. So we can integrate it with the Jenkins so that whenever a new build is triggered, we trigger a job on Jenkins and our test cases automatically run. So it just reduces our manual efforts.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you guys.